Good morning, my dear students. Today we are going to continue the topic, that is chi-square test. Yes, as we have already seen the concept regarding the chi-square test and also the formula and the procedure how to calculate the chi-square test. But now the main thing is that how do we infer or we used to conclude. So conclusion of the chi-square test is very important. So certain different terms is to be considered in this conclusion. So first we must know what are the different terms. So coming up to the topic, that is chi-square test. So chi-square test, as you know that it is a non-parametric test, as we have already discussed it, and it is based on frequencies. That's why it is a non-parametric test and does not depends on other parameters like mean, standard deviation, etc. These are the parametric tests. Mean and standard deviation are example of parametric tests, but chi-square is an example of non-parametric test. And this test is useful for testing the hypothesis. Remember it, this is one of the tests which is used to test the hypothesis and is not useful for estimation. So you can say that mean, standard deviation, it is useful for estimation, but chi-square test is useful for testing the hypothesis. So we have already seen what is the chi-square test. The chi-square test is used to determine whether there is a significant difference between the expected frequency and the observed frequency. मतलब chi-square formula through हम ये find out करते हैं कि जो theoretical frequency है और expected calculated frequency है, उन दोनों में कोई difference है कि नहीं. So if there is any type of significant difference between the expected frequency and the observed frequency or not. So the value of chi-square can be calculated. As you know that first we have to find out the expected ratio frequency, then we have to subtract from the observed minus expected, so whole square, that is divided by e expected frequency. So we have to calculate the chi-square of the first observation, second observation, third observation, and then we have to sum up all that. So that is the summation of observed minus expected, the whole square by e will be the how this will be the calculated value of the frequency. Chi-square test is a type test of significance, and it uses data in the form of frequency. Normally you can say that it uses the data in the form of frequency. What do you mean by frequency? Frequency is nothing but the number of occurrence of an event. So how many times the event occur, that is said to be frequency. And what is chi-square test? Chi-square test, it uses the data. Chi-square test kya karta hai? Data ko use karta hai in the form of frequencies. So Pearson, Karl Pearson test is used to access two type of comparison. Karl Pearson ne do prakar ke comparison karne ke liye chi-square ka upyog kiya jata hai. According to him, the two type of test are the test of goodness of fit. First one is the test of goodness of fit, and another one is the test of independence. From the name itself, it refers that first one, that is test of goodness of fit, it refers that or it establishes whether or not an observed frequency differ from a theoretical frequency. So whatever the theoretical frequency is already given there, so it establish whether or not the observed varies from the theoretical. Matlab observed se theoretical jo frequency hai wo differ karta hai ki nahi, and that fits on whether it is good or not. That is why it is said to be the goodness of fit. मतलब फिट बैठता है कि नहीं अकॉर्डिंग टू द थियोरी. तो ऑब्जर्व फ्रीक्वेंसी आर फिटिंग to the theory or not. Next one is the test of independence. So test of independence, from the name itself, that it is independent, or you can say that it assesses whether the paired observation on two variables are dependent of each other or independent of each other. So here you can find out the two variables, and two variables, they are not dependent on each other, they are independent. That's why we used to say that test of independence. That is, sometime polling response from the people of different nationality is done in order to see if one nationality is related to the response of the other or not. So here the observed and the expected ratio or theoretical ratio is totally independent of each other. So certain characteristic of the chi-square distributions we have to consider in mind. The characteristic are the chi-square value. After calculating the chi-square value, whatever we used to get, it always be positive. So it's never that key chi-square value is negative, it is always positive. Second thing is that key, as we increase the, or you can say that chi-square value increases with increase in the degree of freedom. So you will ask me, what is the degree of freedom? Degree is freedom is written as df, and it is calculated by means of number of observation. So the number of observation minus 1. So consider two observation is given. So 2 minus 1, that is equal to 1. So degree of freedom will be 1. So it is said that key chi-square value increases with increase in the degree of freedom. As the df increases, the chi-square value also increases. And third thing is very important, that is, it is the statistical hypothesis. You can say that estimation of chi-square, it is nothing but the statistical hypothesis. It's not a parameter. So mean, mode, median and standard deviation, these are the parameter. These are all the parameter. But chi-square, it is a hypothesis. So it is a statistical measure of determining the hypothesis. It's not a parameter. That's why it is said to be the non-parametric parameter. So certain terms are very important. One of the term is parametric test. So this is the test in which the population constant like mean, standard deviation, standard error, correlation, coefficient, proportion, etc. ke sare jo hote hain, in sab mein population constant, the data tends to follow one or assumed distribution. So here in all this test, here the data follows one assumed distribution, that is normal distribution, maybe binomial or the Poisson. But in case of non-parametric test, in which no constant of the population is used, ek particular constant population use nahi kiya jata hai, and the data do not follow any specific distribution. Here they used to follow a specific distribution, here it does not follow the specific distribution. So here it, in non-parametric test, it doesn't, for the data does not follow any specific distribution, and no assumption are made on the test. So coming up to the next topic, that is hypothesis. So you say that chi-square is one of the statistical term to it follow the hypothesis or not. It's a type of hypothesis detection. Or you can say that chi-square is a statistic hypothesis. So hypothesis means what? Hypothesis, it is definite statement. Hypothesis मतलब क्या होता है? एक particular type of statement होता है about the population parameter. एक parameter को consider करने के बाद एक statement बनाया जाता है that is definite, that is said to be the hypothesis. So what is hypothesis? Hypothesis. So what is hypothesis is this term is expected to have three components, that is variable, population and the relation between the variable and the population. So few examples of this statistical hypothesis may be certain like diet influence health. Diet influence health. So you can say that it is a type of statement. एक ऐसा statement है which is said to be the hypothesis. Example for diet influence intelligence. Diet influence intelligence. Hygiene influence health and prevent diseases. So these are the few examples. One more example is that regular exercise lower weight retention. So you can say that ki certain statements which used to give a conclusion, that is said to be the hypothesis. So you can say that hypothesis, it has three components. One component is variable, another is population, and the third one is the relationship between the variable and the population. There are several examples of the statistical hypothesis like water, cleanliness prevent gastric diseases, advertisement increase sales of the product, ad increase sales of product, etc. These are the different hypothesis statements. So now you know how to calculate the chi-square. So certain observation is given to you, certain expected value is given to you. If at all expected value is not given to you, you know how to calculate it. And after calculating, we have to draw an inference. So how to draw an inference? So in order to know the how to write the inference, we have to first calculate the chi-square value. So till now you have calculated the chi-square value. So if the calculated chi-square value is less than the tabulated table mein, in case of a particular table is given to you, in that a particular chi-square value is also given to you. So if we have to compare this data from the table data. So if you have calculated the certain chi-square value which is less than the tabulated value, then we used to say that then this values observed and expected values, these the data are insignificant. So we can say that the variables जो को तो जो experiment में variables दिले ले आए हैं या दिया हुआ है, they are independent of each other, means they does not depend on one another. But if the calculated value of the chi-square it is more than, so certain values if you have calculated which is more than the tabulated value, then we can say that these values are significant. Or you can say that the variables तो वॉट एवर द वेरिएबल्स इज गिवेन दैट द वेरिएबल्स डिपेंड ऑन वन अनदर. सो इन दिस वे वी हैव टू ड्रॉ द इन्फ्रेंस एंड वी हैव टू राइट आउट द कंक्लूशन. रिमेंबर ओनली वन थिंग, इफ द कैलकुलेटेड वैल्यू इज लेस देन द वेरिएबल डज नॉट डिपेंड ऑन वन अनदर. मीन्स हेल्थ does not depends on the exercise. Consider the if a particular exercise affects the health, so you can say that health and the exercise does not depend on one another. And if I say if the calculated value of chi square is more than the tabulated value, then we can say that ki health depends on the regular exercises. So in this way we can draw the conclusion. So, see you with the next topic tomorrow. Thank you. Thank you for attending the lecture.